This video series contains scientific and medical concepts aimed at informing healthcare professionals. Please note that the videos may contain visually stimulating images and movement.
A 2018 study queried 150 individuals diagnosed with ME/CFS regarding the triggers, time to onset, symptoms of, and duration of episodes of post-exertional malaise to help elucidate both the overlap and heterogeneity of each individual's experiences with PEM. Among those surveyed, over 90% of these individuals clearly recognized episodes of worsening symptoms consistent with the definition of PEM. Fatigue was universally recognized as the most commonly exacerbated symptom during episodes of PEM. Cognitive difficulties, sleep disturbances, headaches, muscle pain, and flu-like symptoms were all cited by at least 30% of the studied subjects. Integration of these distinct symptoms into general categories yielded a finding that 60% of subjects experienced at least one, if not multiple, inflammatory or immune-mediated symptoms during PEM.
Other notable symptoms cited by subjects included exacerbation of underlying orthostatic, gastrointestinal, neurological, and mood-related symptoms for the duration of their PEM episodes. Duration of episodes of PEM varied even among individual subjects themselves, likely as a consequence of the degree of overexertion triggering each individual episode. 84% of subjects, however, noted enduring PEM for a duration of 24 hours or longer.
Time to onset of an episode of PEM after an inciting exertional trigger yielded particularly diversified responses among subjects, though 11% reported a delay of at least 24 hours between their inciting trigger and the onset of symptoms of PEM. Despite this response data, clinicians who evaluate and treat those suffering with ME/CFS have almost universally recognized that the payback of PEM is often delayed by 24 to 48 hours from an initial triggering event. It is postulated that this discrepancy in data may arise from patients mistakenly interpreting the immediate worsening of symptoms of ME/CFS as a consequence of orthostatic intolerance for an actual episode of post-exertional malaise. In fact, many of those suffering with ME/CFS who additionally experience particularly aggressive symptoms of orthostatic intolerance may discover, upon adequate treatment of their orthostatic intolerance, that they are finally able to exceed a threshold by which they exert themselves sufficiently to induce a true episode of post-exertional malaise. In these instances, onset of symptoms of PEM are indeed delayed up to 24 hours after an initial exertional trigger. As if this delay between action and consequence were not already abundantly complicated, post-exertional malaise need not always be incited by one specific individual trigger. One particularly insightful patient has noted that she can instigate PEM by doing way too much all at once or by doing slightly too much over a span of several days. She reports that the duration and intensity of her symptoms of PEM are often more prolonged and exaggerated when she is struck by PEM as the result of only slightly exceeding her energy envelope for several days in a row. The phenomenon of variable intensity and frequency of triggers for PEM has often been likened to an analogy of debt. Consider, for example, that an individual with ME/CFS may have one metaphorical dollar of energy to spend each day. This individual could go on a spending spree, allocating upwards of $10 of energy expenditure in one day. This splurge might then be followed by an immediate requirement to pay back this debt, beginning the following day and extending until the entirety of the $10 is recouped and paid back. Alternatively, an individual could, perhaps unknowingly, spend $1.25 each day over the course of 2 weeks. While 25 cents of energy debt does not lead to immediate consequences, the accrual of this debt can become a substantial sum that, when PEM does arrive, must be paid back with interest.
This video was made possible by the OMF-funded Medical Education Resource Center at BHC, our generous donors, and viewers like you. Please consider making a tax-deductible donation to help keep educational resources like this one publicly available.